Saludos, it's your host, Gabe Morales. We have been covering Mexican Mafia members over the past 60-plus years. Before we get started, I would like to give a shout-out to The Gray Line, the story behind the blue line. They recently did a story on my career and this podcast. So if you want to check it out, I will put out their podcast website at the end of this video. But once again, thank you guys. Gracias. I thought that was a pretty good interview and the feedback has been tremendous. A lot of these old A and early B numbers came from my mentor, Robert Mocha Morrell, who, yeah, you're probably getting tired of me saying his name, but I can't say enough about this man. He was the first coordinator of the California Gang Task Force and tracked all the early MA members with guys like Sergeant Bill Hankins and MA specialists like Tony Casas. And while you may have not heard of some of these older cats, believe me, there's documentation on them. So if there's anybody still around that remembers some of these old A and B numbers, I'd appreciate a little more insight because I only kept sketchy information on a lot of them. Today, we're going to start off with the T last names, as in Trucha. If you're not familiar with that word, you soon will be. I'll start off with Sheldon Tafoya, who is out of San Francisco. I show he had an A number, 11122, and was born in 1920. I show that he was an MA member by at least the 1970s and was housed in 1974 at California Medical Facility. I'm pretty sure with that DOB, he is now deceased. I also show Roland Talamantes. I believe he was from San Diego. I'm not sure. But he also had an A number, 60225, and came back with a B number of 5397. He was born in 1944. And I show was an MA member by at least the early 70s, and like a lot of these guys, dealt in dope. There was Luis Bala, a.k.a. Vato Talamantes from Venice. He had an A number of 93537. He was born in 1943. I show he was MA by the mid-60s and was housed at San Quentin in the late 60s. I show that he was hit in the shoe war in September 1968 by the NF, but not severely injured. I also show that he was involved in a retaliation hit in 1970 on Nuestra Familia Mexicana founder Chalo Hernandez. He was housed in the Adjustment Center at San Quentin on August 21st, 1971. For those of you not familiar, that is the day that George Jackson was killed. And he was one of the guys who was a supporter of the BGF. I'm not going to say much more about Bala other than that, but he's still out there supporting radical causes. I understand he's not very fond of this channel, but he paroled and is out there doing his thing. There was Nicholas Tomate Tamayo out of Corona. He had a B number of 8394. He was born in 1948, and I show was involved in the MA in the mid-1970s. By the way, I think I mentioned it before, but I used to stay in Corona when I was dating my now current wife. We've been together almost 40 years, but at that time, she was living with her mother, who was a corrections officer at CIM in Chino, and they lived right next to the Barrio Locos on 4th Street there in Corona, which is an old barrio there. I'm not 100% sure, but that's the old part of Corona, and Corona was relatively small back then. My guess is that's the area that Tomate was from. I show a Ramon Tannery, aka Thumper. Understand that his primo was Sleepy Vasquez Escalante from 18th Street, who I'll cover under the V's. Thumper hung out down in Tiwas. I'm not sure if he did any CDC time, but he was at very least a camarada and had 18th Street tattooed on his throat. And I understand he worked for Peanut Butter Ruiz. I believe he was killed with his primo, Sleepy. Then we have Alejandro Fox Tapia from Southside Los. Fox had a C number of 81284 and was born in 1963. I first met Fox in the Violence Control Unit of New Folsom in the early 90s. Later on, he became a carnal, and I remember he was putting in a lot of work. And his moniker fits, although sometimes he seemed to play dumb, like he didn't understand English. I'm pretty sure he knew what was going on the tier. He was in charge of security. Fox was born in Michoacán and had ties to the Familia Michoacana as well as the Templarios, who both operated in that state in various degrees over the years. Understand, in the late 90s, he was engaged in a war against Chuy Martinez, who was a very powerful Emero, and I heard that Fox hired some Jimtown gangsters to hit Chuy. I showed that he was in general population in 2012, but indicted on a RICO case in August of 2013.
In a pre-dawn raid, more than 500 law enforcement officers arrested 32 alleged gang members off the street and 35 alleged members of the Mexican Mafia who were serving time in L.A. County Jail awaiting their trials, transferred them to federal custody, and included in the arrest, the so-called ringleader, Jose Landa Rodriguez, described by some gang experts to me as, quote, the most powerful, influential inmate in county jail.
Landa Rodriguez controlled all drug trafficking in the jails.
The indictment alleges all on orders from Landa Rodriguez, 55 years of age. And the indictment says he had help from an attorney, Gabriel Sendejas Chavez, who was arrested this morning at his home in Ontario.
The contraband is already inside the cell.
Detectives say the Mexican Mafia had such control and the system was so well run that anyone who didn't cooperate or try to go against them was beaten.
Stabbed, kidnapped, and killed.
There was Martin Tejas, who I mentioned in a previous episode. He was considered to be an MA associate at the very least, and was the director of Centro de Pintos, which means Center of Convicts. And as I mentioned in the previous episode, Cheyenne Cadena wrote a letter to his sister directing that Tejas, deliberately misspelled, be sent to Fresno, his place of birth. Next, I'll talk a little bit about Randy Dale Cowboy Therian, who's from Base Grande. He had BOP number of 03324112 and was indicted on the 1995 RICO case. Understand that Cowboy never did time before and folded pretty rapidly. He ended up picking up the Bible and disassociated himself from La M.A. and was housed at Terre Haute, which is a well-known PC facility. I will briefly mention Miguel Huero Thompson, who's from San Diego and was very close to Cheeks Buchanan. He had an F numbers in Frank, 43276. And like I said, may have not have been Emmett, but he was a very strong supporter and also a pretty good artist. I spoke in some of the earlier episodes about Alberto Boxer Tolento. He was from the Avenues, 57 Click. He was involved in a homicide in 1984 and housed in the California Youth Authority. He then graduated to the adult system with D number 12788 and was made MA, I believe, by either the late 1980s or early 90s. He was housed at Pelican Bay for many years where he wielded his authority and then was let out and housed at Kern Valley State Prison in 2016. I show that Tolento is no longer in custody. There was Alfonso Jaguar Torres at Hawaiian Gardens. He had K number 59221. I believe he was made MA sometime in the late 1990s and was housed at Corcoran in 2016, but I show no longer in custody as of at least 2021. There was Eddie, aka Fast Eddie Torres, out of the Avenues. He had a B number of 37032. This guy was very active in 1972 and engaged in war against the Nuestra Familia. Cheyenne Cadena personally wrote him a letter, and I believe he chose Fast Eddie as being one of his representatives to conduct peace talks with the NF. But, of course, after Shy was killed, that was the end of that. And I believe that Fast Eddie dropped out of San Quentin around 1974. There was a John Kiko Torres, showed that he was involved with the MA by at least the mid-70s, and murdered an individual named Luana Gillis in January 1979, as well as a Vic Figueroa in February of 79. Understand he was housed at San Quentin in 1982, but disagreed with some of the MA politics that were going on. So he testified in the RICO case in the mid-90s. There was Michael Mosca Torres, sometimes called Fly, from San Fer in the San Fernando Valley. He had a C number of 55512 and was made MA by none other than founder of Huerba Flores in the early 90s. I showed that he was not validated until 1994 at Pelican Bay. And soon after that, he was one of the individuals who enforced the MA edict that had barely just come out. Mosca was always involved in MA politics. He paroled in 2002 and enforced the MA edict out in the street. Understand he got in a little trouble with the brothers, but was cleared by Huero Smooth Garcia. In the last episode, I talked about Chato Sandoval taking off the green light on the Maravillas. Well, Mosca was one of the individuals who put that green light on in the first place. By 2003, Mosca shared control over the LA County jail system with fellow MM member Armando Perico Ochoa. After Ochoa was sent to prison, Mosca took control. And he had some beef with the Mara Salvatrucha members and extorted Nelson Komandari, who was considered the worldwide leader of MS at that time. Understand that Komandari paid a considerable amount to have the green light taken off. Mosca returned to CDC in December 2007 with a new number of F, as in Frank, 96964. Understand that Fly also had a connection with 18th Street via a guy who was affiliated with 18 down in Central America. Then I understand that Dennis Woody Ortiz, who was a carnal out of Compton, took over that 18th Street connection. And when the kid protested, Mosca okayed the 18th Street youngster to get hit. But as they say, what goes around comes around. He was housed at New Folsom in 2016 and indicted with Aryan Brotherhood members in 2019 while he was still housed at New Folsom. He ended up being stabbed to death on July 6, 2023 at New Folsom.
The California State Prison is investigating the stabbing death of an inmate. According to investigators, two inmates, Juan Martinez and Ray Martinez, attacked and killed 59-year-old Michael Torres. Torres had been serving a 133-year sentence for a list of crimes, including attempted murder, and was a third strike offender. The inmates accused of killing Torres are also serving life sentences.
Shortly after that, several of his supporters were also killed or hit, including his young wife, Stephanie Rodriguez Torres, also known as Lady Mosca, being killed in July 2023 in the San Fernando Valley. Word is that Mosca also put a hit out on a rapper named Little Demon that he had allegedly extorted, but felt was not kicking down the money that he demanded. As I said, Mosca attacks a lot of different barrios, in particular in the San Fernando Valley, which was his area, and made a lot of money for the inmate. Evidently, some thought he pushed too hard and put out too many hits on individuals. Allegedly, the hit on Mosca was sanctioned by high-ranking inmate members for Mosca just abusing his authority too much and burning too many carnales and camaradas. And so ended another career of an inmate member who was king of the hill but got knocked down. There was Manuel Tati, a.k.a. Gordo Torres, from La Rana, but he had moved to Visalia in the late 70s and lived there for many years. As I said in many other episodes, quite a few of these vatos haven't lived or didn't live in their original barrios for decades. Tati had an A number of 74921 and was made MA in the early 1960s. He was involved in the shoe war in 1968 and, I understand, kidnapped a Soledad administrator at one time. In addition to being engaged in the war with the NF in 1968, I understand he was involved in a hit against Nuestra Familia Mexicana founder Chalo Hernandez in 1970 at San Quentin. I understand he was involved in some skirmishes against the blacks involving Shanks in 1973 at San Quentin, and he conducted these with Juan Duran and Bobby Butler of the Aryan Brotherhood. Tati was out by February of 2077 and was present at an MM meeting in February of 1977 that was under surveillance by the gang task force. He attended a baptism in Visalia in 1977. He was the driver on the Gilbert Roybal hit in Fresno in 1977 and was soon arrested. Understand he came back to CDC in the 1990s under H number 32996. Tati had backed Stranger Terzak against Chuy Mariano and also had begun encroaching more on Vic's area in Visalia. As I said, Tati was living in Visalia. He was homeboys with Victor Murillo, who was also from La Rana, who had also moved to Visalia back in the 70s. Vic was indicted on a RICO case and the only one found not guilty. Some tried to say that was because he rolled, but there's no evidence of that. I believe it was just Emmy politics, even though politicking against another carnal is against the rules. And he was killed by Enchanette and Chacho Woody. Tati eventually was indicted on a RICO case and convicted and sent to the feds under BOP number 587-47097. Many of the carnales blamed Tati for the death of Victor Murillo, so court was held. And I understand Champ Reynoso gave the final verdict of the death penalty. And so, as I covered in the last episode, Tati was stomped to death by Chuco Santiago and Silvestre Rivera in April 2005. It was the first documented murder at the ADX. There was Max James Mono Travisco from Barrio Nueva Estrada. I understand he also encroached on Vic Murillo's area. Travisco told jurors that he personally carried out three murders and participated in numerous shootings and stabbings in support of the MA. I believe he was just a camarada because he was only 24 years old when he took the witness stand against 11 suspected MA members and associates, but claimed he was recruited into the MA in 1998. Regardless, his testimony helped in more than 50 convictions in at least a half a dozen trials. He even testified against his former mentor, MMA shot caller Mariano Chuy Martinez, who received life in prison plus 130 years. I already mentioned several times in previous episodes, Thomas Hapo Trejo from Clover. He was killed at Lompoc in 1978 on the orders of Champ Reynoso and sanctioned by other medals like Willie Bobo, Blackie Segura, and Black Bob Ramirez. I show a Eloy Gordo Triana, who's from Hazard and had an A number of 90371, who was born in 1943. He joined the MMA sometime in the 1960s and appeared on some MMA cards in the late 60s, but paroled by 1974 and disappeared from the radar. It was Christian Bomber Trigg, who originally is from San Bernardino, but also had ties to Seattle, Washington. There's another one, even though people say there's never been any MMA in Washington State. Bomber had a E number of 99056 and had been housed at the King County Department of Youth Services, where I often visited and talked to the youth in 1987. He did time in Washington DOC under number 946627. He ended up getting released, but is involved in meth cells and indicted by the feds, whereby he was sent to Lompoc in 1998 under BOP number 11383112. Understand that he did a hit on some gangster disciples in the federal system and was housed in Marion in 2003 through 2004. He then was moved to the ADX, but was released in April 2022. I will mention Martin, aka Fat Marty Trill, who's out of Broderick. Broderick has been known as a Norteño stronghold in past years, as well as a heavy Northern Rider area in later years. Fat Marty may have not been a carnal, but he was Nico Velasquez's cellie. So he was very close to the MMA at Folsom Prison. He had a C number of 83894. There was Manuel Smiley Tristan from Westside 18th Street. He was MMA in the 1970s with a B number. Understand that he killed a cop and eventually dropped out of the MMA. There was Isidro Fritos Trujillo. He had an A number of 855794. I have him down as being just an MMA associate during the Shoe War of 1968, but then, I understand, earned his bones and was accepted into the clica. He ended up running afoul of the MMA, and on January 16, 1977, he was killed by Mike Delia, who I understand was assisted by Huito Marquez, Robot Salas, and Alfie Sosa, and was buried on Mike Delia Sr.'s property in Palmdale. And finally, we have John, a.k.a. Stranger, a.k.a. John the Czech, Turksack out of Rockwood. He was convicted on a robbery in 1987 and given E number 25001. Understand that he murdered an NF member, whereby he earned his stripes and was considered a canal, and was housed at Folsom Prison in 1990. He ended up getting a parole violation in 1997 when he started working for the Fed, all the time while he's engaging in a war with Chuy Martinez's faction of the MMA. And Stranger was involved in a lot of crimes. Some say it was okayed by his handlers. His handlers kept him on a long leash and told him he could do pretty much anything but murders. Chuy Martinez's crew went after Stranger, including trying to kill him in April 1998 in front of his mom's house. Stranger was indicted in the RICO case in 1999 and testified against MMA members. He was housed in Atlanta in 2003 and 2004 and at Coleman in 2012. Under BOP number 14098-074. He is scheduled to be released in mid-2026. And so, I don't have any words of wisdom for you today, except for stay trucha, stay aware, and take care. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to check out The Gray Line, the story behind the blue line. Those are some good brothers there, and they've had some good guests on their show. Many of those who have influenced me as far as my knowledge in the gang world and police and corrections field. For now, this is Gabe Morales signing off for Gangsters, Cops, and Politicians. Open your eyes. I think that's